This video is a quick introduction to aggregate demand, including its definition and components. Aggregate demand is the total demand for final goods and services in an economy at a specified time. The diagram on the right will be explained in a later video, but the key thing to notice is that the diagram slopes downwards as the price level falls. Why that happens exactly, we will explore later. Aggregate demand is equal to consumption, investment, government spending, and net exports added all together. Consumption includes all spending by consumers on goods and services, such as haircuts, education, clothing, food, and housing. In the United States, it makes up the largest component of GDP at about 68%. For comparison, that figure is 80% in Pakistan, 65.1% in the UK, and about 37% in China. Investment includes planned business spending on capital goods and inventories, business spend on plant, equipment, and machinery, as well as stock. These are all included under the category of investment. Comparing the same countries as before using 2012 figures, China is at about, or was at about, 46% of GDP, Pakistan at 10.9%, the US at 12.8%, and the UK at 14.2%. Government spending includes all spending by the government on final goods and services such as defense, education, and healthcare. It does not include transfer payments, as when money is exchanged in these conditions, it is not given in exchange for a good or service. It constitutes 23.9% in China and 19.8% in Pakistan. This information is provided by the Wall Street Journal and the Heritage Foundation. The reference is included in the video description. Net exports are calculated by subtracting imports from other countries away from the exports to other countries. Exports are considered an injection into the economy as money is coming from outside the country, and imports are considered a leakage as money is leaving the country. Per the World Bank, China's percentage is 22.1% of GDP, Pakistan is 10.6%, the US is about 12.6%, and the UK is at 27.2%. Again, the reference is in the video description. That concludes this video on aggregate demand. In the next video, we'll take a look at why it slopes downwards and what can cause it to shift. I'll see you in the next one.